Thank you very much, Mr. Chair, distinguished guests, my colleague ambassadors on the dais, ladies and gentlemen. From the program, I notice that I am the last speaker before lunch. So let me start with a story as far as lunch is concerned. My Russian colleague talked about a Russian wise man. Let me talk about what an Indian wise man said. He said that 100 people go and attend a conference. They all look worried about the future of the world. After the conference they come out, they are still worried about the future of the world. The same 100 participants go attend a lunch. They are worried about the future of the world, but when they come out of the lunch, they are looking satisfied. So I would like to be brief in my remarks and would not like to hold you from lunch for too long. And secondly, a wise man said that time management is life management. If we can manage our time well, we can manage our life properly. Let me first of all say that this is my second visit to Verona. It's a beautiful city. And indeed, the way the city has been maintained, the way its old character has been maintained, I think it's a lesson for all those who come, both for tourism, for work, for conferences. It's an example that rest of the world can emulate. So my compliments to the mayor in absentia and his entire team and all the organizers who've done a wonderful job to put together this conference. India has had deep historical and civilization contacts with the countries of Eurasian region from time immemorial. In ancient times and medieval times, there used to be contact through trade, commerce, exchange of travelers, culture, language between India and the entire Eurasian region. Both sides have influenced the cultures of each other. As far as Russia is concerned, it's a long-standing, time-tested partner. Since the signing of India-Russia strategic partnership, India has enhanced cooperation with Russia in all spheres, including political, security, trade, economy, defense, science and technology, culture, etc. Under strategic partnership, both the countries have institutional linkages and dialogue mechanisms. The strategic partnership in 2010 was elevated to the level of special and strategic partnership. So far, 15 annual summit meetings have been organized. Both India and Russia are members of BRICS, which has helped both the countries to take unified stand relating to international economy and finance. We cooperate with Russia in the fields of defense, space technology, and our trade covers a wide range of items, including pharmaceutical, manufacturing items, steel and iron, power equipment, fertilizers, electrical machinery, steel, and diamonds. The Central Asian region in the Eurasian region, India has been linked by trade and cultural exchanges through the ancient Silk Route. Two important and ancient civilizations, notably Mesopotamia and Indus Valley, were founded in the Eurasian region. In post-Cold War era, this region has acquired greater geopolitical strategic importance. India has very strong foundation for developing strong political and economic relationship with the Ukraine, Belarus, other Baltic countries, and Caucasian countries. As far as the countries in the Central Asia are concerned, long-standing historical and civilization links of those countries with India has helped furthering mutual relationship. Some of the factors that have helped this intensification of ties include the geographical and security significance, India's need for energy, and resource-rich countries of CIS. Trade and investment. Historically, Central Asia was used as a transit route. Presently, the trade of India with CIS countries is below its potential. Central Asia has a huge market for products and services which India can offer and for setting up joint ventures. We complement in terms of resources, manpower, and markets. Free trade agreement with Eurasian Economic Union will boost India's relations with member countries, but also give opportunities to deepen ties in economic and strategic areas. Through India's soft power, India wants to expand cultural rapport with CIS countries. As you know, on 21st June, the United Nations declared it the International Yoga Day, and yoga, pranayama, meditation are other areas where we have a lot of commonalities with the European region, Eurasian region. Situated at the crossroads of Asia and astride one of the busiest sea lanes of the world, India faces many security challenges. Defense and security are fundamental obligations of India and are essential requisites for its national, social, economic advancement and transformation. We attach top priority to these tasks. We seek peace, stability, friendship and cooperation in our region and beyond. India seeks to achieve its security and foreign policy goals through use of soft power and diplomacy, through dialogue, scrupulously avoiding use of any coercive power with other countries, increased engagement in neighborhood, deepening economic and strategic obligations in the Indian Ocean, Asia Pacific, West Asia, membership in multilateral region and intra-regional agencies and groupings will help India to face the emerging challenges and to orient and reorient its policies accordingly. Briefly touching on India's relations with EU countries, I wish to highlight India was one of the first countries to develop relations with the European Union. Joint political statement of 93-94 cooperation agreement were the foundational agreements for bilateral relationship. In 2004, India became a strategic partner with EU, and bilateral trade with EU has been to the tune of $101 billion for the fiscal period 2014-15. European Union is our second largest trading bloc, accounting for 20% of India's trade, and we hope that with both the Eurasian region, Central Asia, and EU countries, I think with the entire region, India will be able to enhance its ties in the years to come. Once again, I thank you very much for this time. Thank you.